This is Ash Cave at Hocking Hill State Park. The natural phenomena I drove all this way to see is a gorge, a deep gorge, a deep and wide gorge, cut out by Pine Creek. Certainly this can't be Pine Creek, capable of cutting a wide gorge, 200 feet deep and 100 feet wide. I'll find out later. Interesting how this camcorder compensates for darkness. It's quite dark here in this little arbor, if that's what you could call it. A scrapbook on fungi? I'd rather have a scrapbook on Indians or trains or this boardwalk looks like that at the Maumee Bay State Park. How quaint. This is like a fork in the road. If you want to go straight ahead, well, it's fairly easy on that bridge. However, if you want to take a right turn, go across this little creek, well, the bridge to do that is a little less convenient. I wonder what denizens of forest darkness would overtake a person if he did in fact wander off the trail. It certainly is amazing that these rock cliffs in this gorge were hollowed out by this small creek here many eons ago. This creek certainly has conked out since then, that's for sure. It may be that when this video was played, this cave might look real deep, like it would go way back, but not so. It's only about 8 feet deep, so you couldn't get lost in this cave. I could probably manage to get lost in this one, but no one else could. The baby's way up there. And as always, you continue to hear the rattling of, what, cicadas? Those locust-type things? Maybe sometime today I'll find out. There's much beautiful scenery here, but there's one thing missing, and that's other people. Since school just let out, it may be that mothers are having to break their kiddies of the habit of getting up and walking to school. Maybe those kids still want to go to school, and mother just can't get them to take a summer vacation. Hey, I just happened to think, this is just like Springfield, except the creek is much smaller, much less dramatic. Oh, I understand now. Those tracks, that stain like on the rock spill, that's the marks of a little waterfall. Ordinarily, this whole creek bed is running with water, just as Rock Run Creek in Springfield. We've had such a dry, a relatively dry winter and spring, relatively speaking, mind you, that everything's all dried up. I wonder how Niagara Falls is doing. That would sure hurt the tourist trade if Niagara Falls wound up like this due to the relatively dry early part of this year. Well, this is a miniature ash cave, which is up the road a piece. Well, I finally found a waterfall. Great naturalist that I am. Probably can't see it, but you ought to be able to hear it. And there's where it's fallen on that rock. All half a gallon per hour of the water there. There are fish in here. Saw one a minute ago. Let's see if I can zoom in on one. Yeah, see the little devil swimming around there? This water's so clear, it looks like they're just flying around above the ground, doesn't it? Well, I think that's pretty neat. Even though they're not anything exotic like brook trout, they're just old lake old shiners. Sure like to see this under flooded conditions. Beautiful woods and cliffs. And you can hear these cicadas. I've been told they're cicadas that do this every 17 years. They make a big noise like this, and then as it gets hotter out, it'll get louder and louder. So we'll listen in on that a little later, around high noon. What a drop, huh? With a view like this of the Hocking Hills, it's easy to see that Ohio is indeed another one of our mountain states. Yes, these hills are a bit more pronounced than the hill at Crampton Park, no doubt about that. Right now I'm supposed to be standing in the middle of a waterfall, but it's bone dry. I just passed some people on the trail that were from France. That was French, ladies and gentlemen. More geological formations. Carved out over the millennia by raging torrents through this gorge. Digging this gorge, and now we have Conkle's Hollow. You can see this little guy here. Well, he just flew away, but that was a Cicada, and he, among billions of other Cicadas, are making all this racket. Every time I zoom out, he starts flying, and then I zoom in to get him, and he hides on me. Maybe he'll fly again. There he goes. Somewhere into the abyss. Had him there a minute ago. Such unspoiled natural beauty that the Lord God has created. And here is the remains of yet another derelict dead waterfall. There's a sign that discusses this waterfall in back of me. Let's go up and see just what it says. This waterfall plunges. This definitely is a dried up version of the Rock Run Creek in Springfield that I camcorded several years ago. Time out for more documentation. This is what they call a fissure. And as I look way, way, way down in the fissure, I guess I could say that right now I'm a deep sea fisherman. Guess that's a raccoon. Disappearing into the foliage. The travel guide said that this gorge had many waterfalls. My gosh, what would a cancerous lung be doing on a cliff like this? I think this is amazing. The only real water I've seen, the most water I've seen, is right here by the parking lot. The parking lot of this area I'm leaving now, known as Conkle's Hollow.